Hello everyone, welcome to a video with me, Winner Andre, to pick up my laptop. Last time where I went and started actually taking over countries in Europe by going along, taking over all the countries I bordered over here in Europe, and also went and took over all of England. All the countries that were over there. So, yeah. Can't really exactly see all the land I took in. Promisability at this point, but you can kind of see that with population, since all the other countries start with such a large population in all their provinces, mainly because my country is so large that my population is spread out across the entire country. So yeah, kind of see all the lands I took over right there. So yeah, to start off with here, I think I'm going to take over these countries in Ireland first. And then I will see if I actually want to go to them next or not. Taking over the Scots. And there we go. That should be all of those countries done. So all that's left to do over here is to take yours. Take them over, and I have all of the British Isles in my control. There we go. I guess I'll just go ahead and take them over. And they accepted. Nice. There we go. So, let's see. Let's get a port built right there, since there's kind of not any up here in Scotland. There. Okay, now, have that done, so next up is to focus over here on Europe again. Rest of this. So, Saxony, you're next. Let's see if you'll accept this ultimatum or not. I'm just going to take a guess that you won't, since you have nearly 500,000 population. So, I'm going to go ahead and start lining up troops on this border here with you, since I think you're not going to accept that. Yeah, they didn't accept. So now I just have to wait for my troops to line up here along their border. Hope that 2,000 troops is going to be enough to take those two provinces. There we go. You're currently the ninth strongest country in the world, huh? Well, I previously took over what was basically the eighth strongest country in the world. To be honest, all those countries in the top 10 kind of fluctuate around quite a bit in their ranking, except for those at the very top. So, yeah, Parthian Empire over here is currently second, and they're also one country that I'll absolutely have to go to war with if I want to go into Asia, considering I can't colonize lands currently. I kind of don't want to send troops over here to attack navally, so yeah, I'll be forced to go to war with them eventually. And also the Chinese country, or here, whichever one it is again, is third place right now, I think. Yeah. Or that undiscovered country right there, I think. So, Saxony, a war with you here should be over very quickly, since you don't built stands a chance against me at all. And they successfully defended us. Great. The 2,000 troops wasn't enough. And there we go. I already have all the lads. Now to go and take that up there. And there we go, Saxony has been defeated. Now, let's quickly get these other countries dealt with. Going to wait to take them over, considering they have that land over there. So, you, I'm going to send insults to you currently, so I can send an insult, send an ultimatum. And hopefully get Denmark under my control very quickly. Now, of course, I don't accept that. Sure, whatever. Guess I'll go ahead and get ready to fight them. Then. Meanwhile, I deal with province built here. Of course. Now, let's go out and try and take them over again here. Go to war and take them over by force then, since they still refuse to accept. Now get all those troops sent over there while I take that and deal with a little bit of province stability there. There we go. Also, that country apparently didn't accept the ultimatum I sent them. Wow. Okay. Guess I do need to recruit a larger army soon anyways. Since I'm kind of starting to get a bit low on troops. Lost like half the army I had. There we go. Even larger army than what I've ever actually had, so yeah. Should be easier to take over countries now. Right now, let's just get these troops sent up there to group up with the rest of my army. There we go. Now, let's see if they rethink this ultimatum, now that I have a larger army. And I will also now start working on going into Sweden, taking over these countries, and of course also taking over Sweden themselves. Borders over here aren't great for me right now. So got more province built over here still, apparently. Great. Okay, there. Good. Now, let's see about taking over this country. Which is basically the largest country warfare that I need to take over still. Well, there we go. All of that is now under my control here. here. Well, just a few more turns to finish tank up there. So let's just go ahead and send this ultimatum. It's 19 provinces, okay. And they accepted. I honestly didn't expect them to do that. Okay then, I guess I'll go and quickly take over the rest of these countries then. So, Sweden is now next up for me to take over. I'm going to go ahead and start grouping up these troops over here. Since I don't think I'm going to need tons over here to fight Sweden. If I even have to fight Sweden, that is. Well, all that was a lot easier to get than I expected it to be. So, right now, let's build up a little bit of money since I spent it all on province ability there. Now, Sweden. Let's see if he will accept this ultimatum. You do. Okay. Then in that case, the rest of this army is going down here to group up the rest of it. Since I'm basically now completely done with Europe. There we go. Finally have all that province ability completely done. So, yeah. These two countries are here now towards each other, so I guess if I had to wait and do that. So for now I guess I'll see about taking out these two African countries and also maybe take over these three here. Yeah. So, let's start off with this one right here. And now this one. Which may be a bit harder to do. Because there's a chance that they may not actually accept this ultimatum, I think. Tribes getting a bit bigger. For some reason, they're colonizing north instead of just expanding around their capital. Sure. Okay, nice, they both accepted that. Good. Means they can easily go through and take all that and now deal with province stability. Next up is to take over some of these countries or you get the least. And there we go. Got that stretch of land done. This one here is next. Let's see. Okay, they've taken over all that land. Sure. Well, guess they're next up now. They finished that war that they are fighting. Parthian Empire, twice as large population with 1.8 million. Also, of course, much better economy than them. That's still absolutely nothing compared to me. Okay. There's three countries right there to take over, two right there. Parthian Empire. And over here, there's four, five? Yeah, five right there. Okay. So, 12 countries over here to take over before I really start going into Asia. Okay. Sure. There's going to be a lot of countries over here in North. Over here in the Americas, I'm pretty sure. Considering the fact that there's still 144 countries. And, well, I've already taken over Europe, basically. So, yeah. Either there's a ton of countries right over here, or there's a bunch over here in the Americas. I guess Japan would also be separate in tons of small clans. I don't know. So, yeah, I think that there's going to be the end of this video. I'll take over all those countries right there, and maybe go toward the Parthian Empire the next episode. Depends on how much progress I managed to make, which I probably won't get all that done quite quickly, so yeah, it probably will be taking over the Parthian Empire in the next episode as well. So yeah, I've already made all this progress in just three episodes. Great! I'll be over here by the end of the next one of my episodes. And this here is the largest my army has been so far. Just 52,000 troops. And that's it. Yeah. But yeah. That there will be the end of this video. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I'll see you all in the next one. Bye bye!